My name's Fiona Sharp and I'm from the Wheels in Debussy. Last year I decided that I really wanted to put on a festival in Rugby and Daventry to commemorate the Armistice. It's going to be 100 years this year. I've also got three young children, so I really wanted to make it accessible to younger generations. And with support from Heritage Lottery Fund and Arts Council England, this idea has become a reality. So what is the Armistice Festival? The Armistice Festival includes world-class performances and ambitious community events in Rugby and Daventry, with events taking place this October and November. So what do we have going on at the festival? Well, we have Paul Nash Inspires, a series of art workshops in primary schools leading to work exhibited locally. We have poetry workshops in secondary schools leading to poetry performances in local venues. We have a composer working on miniatures with local secondary schools. These will be performed by some of the UK's most compelling musicians. We have a deeply moving piece called Black Dog, The Dreams of Paul Nash by Dave McKean, which was originally a 1418 Now commission. And Dave will also be exhibiting his work alongside some original World War I artefacts, which have been provided by Rugby School. And our most ambitious piece, Be Brave and Come Home Safe, is a community event written by BAFTA-nominated writer Martin Riley. There's probably about 200 people who will be performing, amateurs and professional musicians.
On Sunday, I arrived in the trenches. I was in charge of number 13 platoon. I was shown the length of trench for which my platoon was responsible. I thoroughly examined the whole trench, the machine gun positions, bombs, and places where you get over, and charge, and deliver a counter-attack.
I'm Dan McLean, and I'm Head of Philosophy and Theology here at Rugby School and Deputy Housemaster of Sheriff. This is Mr. Podmore, Lieutenant Colonel Podmore. He was a member of staff here at Rugby, and he taught here between 1910 and 1914. As soon as the war started, he was one of five or six members of staff who joined up straight away, and he went and joined a battalion of the Northamptonshire Regiment, where his commanding officer was another fellow old rugbyan, and he was promoted very, very quickly. In 3 years he went from being a second lieutenant to being a lieutenant colonel, and by 1917 he was commanding a battalion of the Middlesex Regiment in Belgium. Unfortunately, he was killed on New Year's Eve 1917, just before midnight, just before the new year, by a box of ammunition which exploded in his trench. When he was killed, some of his former pupils had this portrait painted and presented it to the school. So I was in the school archives looking for anything that might help me to organise events for the centenary of the Armistice in 1918, and I saw a suitcase that caught my eye because it looked like a film prop, because of the stickers it had on it that were Paris, Florence, etc., places like that. And I opened it up and saw that it was full of letters, and they were all addressed to Second Lieutenant Louis Stokes, Royal Marines, and stamped 1916. So I had a further look through and realised that essentially it was his whole life in a box. All of his letters home from the age of 13 when he arrived here at Rugby, right up to when he was 19 and died at the Battle of the Somme as a second lieutenant. Photos of him from being a toddler, age 2 or 3, right up to being 19. All of his school reports and his school bills and invoices, everything to do with his life, everything in print between the ages of 13 and 19.
A Song of the Woods to the Big Wolf, December 1911, by Louis Mander Stokes, aged 14. White wolf, lone wolf, howling up the gale, The twilight's drawing cold and grey, and only where the fading day down the wood is gleamy pale. Is there light? Is there light? Read by Caspar Jason Henry Gleave, aged 14.
In their hundreds till Ludlow come in for the fair. There's men from the barn and the forge and the mill and the fold. The lads for the girls and the lads for the liquor are there, and there with the rest are the lads that will never be old. I wish one could know them. I wish there were tokens to tell the fortunate fellows that now you can never discern. And then one could talk with them friendly and wish them farewell and watch them depart on the way that they will not return.